Watch the entire video because this is an honest review. I'm gonna show you the full test of SUNC, and remember, higher result means the tool is more powerful and can run more scripts. I'm gonna show also if the tool crashes, if it stays attached when switching games, and whether the user interface has any bugs. This is the honest review of Bunni. Disclaimer. Before this video starts, I just want to make a few things clear. I do not promote or encourage exploiting. This video is for educational purpose only, and I won't be showing any full scripts or direct exploits. Everything in this video will be blurred or partially shown to prevent misuse. The goal here is to simply test the limits of the Roblox anti-cheat system and see how it reacts. And today's video is sponsored by Roblox Cheats, a website where you can discover premium tools like Celeware, Bunni and Wave and much more all in one place. Use the code Mirko to get a discount and the link is in the pinned comment. As always, use those tools in private games because those are not allowed on public servers. Now let's talk about Bunni. So the link for this is also in the pinned comment and make sure you have a program to open this, for example 7-zip. You can search them on Google. Now, create a new folder on your desktop and name it Bunni. Drag all the files, so not only one, in the folder like this. Now we are good to go. You can open Bunni. As you can see, there is a key system. I already did it. It took me like 5 minutes and the key lasts 24 hours. So let me copy it and continue. So this is the user interface and I really like it. Let's try if all the buttons work. So the clear button is working, the open script is working, and the save script, it's working. We also got a console. Here you will see everything you do. Run a script, the console will track it. And there is the touch button on the top right. Let's go in the settings. We got topmost. This will make the window stay on top. Then we have enable minimap. Let me save changes and it will show you this, basically a preview of what you are typing in the editor. I'm gonna keep it off. Multi-instance allows multiple instances of Roblox to run, so very useful. Error spoofing is not already a feature yet, and redirect Roblox output. It will show the Roblox output in the console. Now I will see if it crashes. So I'm not gonna cut the video. Let's see if it crashes on the first inject. I'm gonna try to attach first in the menu and see what happens. Injected, and it did not crash apparently. Let's try to join a game and see if something happens. Apparently nothing happened. Let me try to print something in the console. Remember that this is a private game. You cannot use this on public games. I'm just testing the anti-cheat. As you can see, it's working, so we are connected. The console is not showing anything. Now I'm gonna switch games and also see if it remains attached and also check for the SUNC. So let's go on the SUNC game. Okay, we are on the SUNC game and I swear to God, I'm not a furry. So let's go print and let's see if it's still injected. That will mean it has a TP under. Yes, we are still injected. Very useful if you want to switch games without re-injecting. Now I'm gonna run the SUNC script and show you the result. Okay, we got the result. It did not crash. The exploit did not crash a single time. This is like the free exploit with the highest SUNC and with a key system. So shout out to them. So alright, time for my final talks. Drum roll please. This is Mirko's final vote. 9 out of 10. This exploit has a smooth UI, almost all settings are working good. I gave it a 9, not because the key system, but because there is not a script up yet. But other than that, the UI is smooth, it doesn't crash, it has the highest SUNC I ever saw on a free exploit, so it's really worth checking out. Thank you so much for watching, guys.